Who will win the golden mask? The fox or the Rottweiler? Find out when we come back on The Masked Singer.
Bye-bye.
Who is that?
Hey, so Fox and Rottweiler, here's what's going to happen. Nick's going to bring us back. He's going to essentially go to who the winner is.
Oh, gosh. Man, you're going to find out who the winner is. Great. Ah, look at that.
Oh.
Well, they're related species, dog and fox.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
This is it. We're about to reveal the winner of The Masked Singer. Who will take home the golden mask? Will it be the fox? Or the Rottweiler?
Wow, it's like equal.
The winner of this season's golden mask is...
I'm scared.
Oh, man.
The Fox!
Yes! Fox,
congratulations!
Wow!
Look at that love right there.
Oh my God, it's so cute. It's so cute to see them hug.
Fox, you are the king of The Masked Singer. Please make your way over to the throne.
He fought for that. He did.
The fox is holding it down. You can see the excitement in the fox over there.
So happy!
Ladies and gentlemen, give it up for our runner-up, the Rottweiler. Now, panel, this has been a long journey. But before we go any further, who on earth do you think the Rottweiler is?
Well, honestly, this is one of the best voices we've ever had on this show.
Yes.
Originally, it gave me more rock alternative vibes. I thought you were someone from Fall Out Boy, Patrick Stump,
yep,
or from Incubus. But in the clue package, it started to talk about makeup, and I know that this person wore makeup at the Met Ball and recently got married. So I'm gonna go with Darren Criss.
That's a good one.
Yeah, I agree with Nicole. I think the very first performance, he has such a great range. The way he moved, he had swag. And so I was thinking it was from a boy band, maybe somebody like Brian Littrell of the Backstreet Boys. But then we got into the musical theater and we heard more songs. I think it's Darren Criss, very talented young man.
Okay.
Dog, you've had me all over the place because when you first came out the first time, I was like, oh, Robin, this is like an R&B guy. Listen to that voice. Then the next week, I was like, oh, Robin, this is definitely a boy bander. But based off of your amazing vocal ability, I kept thinking, like, who can sing like that? And for some reason, I flashed to Jason Mraz.
All right.
That's a good guess. Good
thank
guess.
You. Thank you.
That's good.
Wow.
Uh-oh, he's already standing. Dr. Ken.
All right, we've been through a long and winding journey with the Rottweiler. We've gone from boy banders in the very beginning, and then, my favorite guess, Bow Wow. But in all seriousness, I think it's someone who is known for one thing and is freeing to be something else. So right now, I'm going with a friend of mine, Dave Franco. He's of a similar build. He's not known as a singer, but has an amazing voice, so I think I'm right.
Well, you never know.
All right, well, we have you all on record, so it's time to see if any of you are right. Rottweiler, show the world who is behind the mask. Take it off!
Take it off! Take it off! Take it off!
Yeah! in the world made you do this show?
Man, I wanted to do something fun. I wanted to challenge myself. Saw it last year when T-Pain won. I was like, oh, I just want to do this. That looks like so much fun.
Oh, man.
I had no idea how challenging it was going to be. I'm so happy I did it. And my kids have no idea I'm doing this, so I'm so pumped for them to see this.
Oh. Y'all cool dad is. He's the Rottweiler.
I'm so happy you did this show because we all know that you have an unbelievable voice. You blew us out of the water week after week.
Out.
This is crazy. Now, to sing for us one last time, unmask the phenomenal Chris Daughtry.
I'm alive.
The moment we've all been waiting for, we'll find out who's behind the mask of our season 2 champion, the Fox. Breathe.